In this video, I'm going to take you through the toolbar. You may have noticed already that the modules have a very similar look and feel to the toolbar, so I'm just going to go into one module and demonstrate this for you. In your currencies module, you'll notice the toolbar across the top, similar to the other modules as well. So the first button is new, so if you need to create a new currency, you would select right here. Then we can edit currencies that already exist. You must first select the currency that you want to edit before you click on. And then you can make your changes once you're in this screen and save those if you've made the right changes. We can also delete currencies. Again, you'd need to select which ones you want to delete first. We can also find certain currencies. So let's click on Find and do a quick search. Let's say we're looking for Canadian dollars. We can search within the current selection that was on the screen, or we can perform deep search inside all fields. Let's leave these blank for now and see what we come up with. And you see Canadian dollars has been found. This leads me to your All button on your toolbar. Once you select, it will bring through all of the currencies that you have in this module. Now we can do some filters. First of all, select the currencies that you want to filter out. We'll just do a small selection for this example, and then click Filter. You'll see that everything else has been filtered out. Now we can save this filter. This would be, for example, we are working on something within this within these currencies, and we don't want to lose what we were working on. So we can then go back to All, go away from the computer, come back, want to work on that filter again. So then we can load that filter that we did, and it will bring back what we saved originally. You can do this multiple times, but each time it will save over the old filter. So for example, let's do a different filter. Save it. Click back on All. Then we click back on Load, and you'll see that the new filter that we saved has now been pulled. We can also sort our currencies. So if we click on Sort, we then have to put in the fields that we want to sort it by. So for example, we can sort it by currency code by dragging and dropping, or selecting and hitting the arrow across. Then we order, and it will be sorted by code. We can print from this screen, and we can also export to HTML format.